Chapter 167, Sending Sheep into the Tiger's Den. The Na tribe sorcerer Holy Land was a hallowed ground that only the current Witch Queen and her successors knew the location of. This land was the tribe's ultimate legacy. Inside was contained the mysterious power of the sorcerer. Foreigners were absolutely not allowed to enter. Otherwise that would desecrate the land of the sorcerer and blaspheme his name. Although her tribe had already perished, Na, he would rather die in order to maintain the long-gone glory of her people. But now, her younger sister had fallen into the hands of these two beasts. And thinking of the tragically pitiful fate that would befall her little sister was like a sizzling knife that pierced Na Yi's heart. She could do naught but repeatedly delay her compromise in order to protect her. The monkey-faced man had found out that Na Yi was intentionally delaying, so he had given her a warning earlier. "Hehe, big brother, if I don't give these two little girls a taste of what we can do, then they won't know just how fierce us double demons of the southern wilderness are. Tonight, I will bring the younger girl into a room to train well, and show her what it means to be a woman." As the bald man said this, he leered at Na Shui with an obscene smile. Pitiful Na Shui paled, hiding behind Na Yi as she shivered. "If you dare to touch her, I will immediately cut off my meridians and die," Na Yi said as she stepped back, one hand protecting her little sister and the other clenched against her chest. She gritted her teeth, and began to revolve the true essence within her body. Her angry eyes were the same as a small leopard as she glared at the bald man. There was no doubt about it. She was someone who could follow up on her words. The bald man's aura was weakened as Na Yi stared him down. He bitterly stepped back. Although his strength far surpassed Na Yi, if they compared their aura, then he had not been able to suppress her. Number 2. Don't mess with the sisters. Only the elder sister knows a way to open the path to the sorcerer Holy Land. If she commits suicide, then we won't be able to get anything at all. When we succeed in obtaining the power of the sorcerer, then your strength will rise to the pulse condensation period. At that time, you can have any woman you desire. You have to look forward to the goal ahead, the monkey-faced man said with a true essence voice transmission. I was just thinking that, the bald man muttered as he lasciviously licked his lips. I don't really care about the younger one, but that Na Yi witch is someone I don't usually see. I like her strong temper. If I could bring her to bed, then she would be surely full of flavor. In the evening, Lin Ming spent the night at an inn within the small tribe. The next day, he bought a tent, rope, a variety of antidotes, and a worming wine before he once again entered into the forest of the wilderness. The wild forest was not dense. Rather, it was often dotted with large tracts of grasslands and marshes. Lin Ming left the tribe and walked for about a quarter of an hour. Gradually, the surroundings became increasingly desolate. Suddenly, he heard the faint sound of hoofbeats behind him. After a little time, four people on deep red mountain horses rode up in Lin Ming's sight. They were the two men and two young girls that he had seen yesterday. These four people were probably deliberately following me. Lin Ming had a very strong perception. When he was buying things on the street, he had noticed the two men hiding in the inn, and occasionally peeking out to observe him. As they caught up with Lin Ming, the two men reined in their horses, and heartily laughed as they dismounted. The waxy monkey-faced man warmly asked, "Little brother, are you out for an adventure?" Lin Ming cupped his hands together in greeting and said, "Yes, I heard that the southern wilderness had a rich wealth of hidden treasures, so I came here to test my own luck. I wanted to see if I can obtain any medicinal grasses that I can use for elixirs, while gaining some experience." The bald man laughed as he heard this and then growled, "Little brother, you've come to the right place. The southern wilderness is incomparably vast. There are countless rare birds and beasts here, and endless amounts of precious materials and treasures. However, there are also many dangers, and the terrain is complex. It's very easy to get lost here. Little brother, if this is your first time coming to the southern wilderness, then how about traveling with us? We are very familiar with the surrounding areas, and our strength is also decent. How about it?" As the two men spoke, Lin Ming noticed that the little girl behind the man was anxiously biting her lip. She was looking at him with wide eyes, and there seemed to be a hint of distress, confusion, and fear within them. Lin Ming's mind stirred. It seems as if this little girl has something to say, but she can't say it. Is it because she fears these two men? It looks like the relationship between the two girls and these two men isn't friendly. As Lin Ming thought this, he secretly scanned the two men. These two men had a very fierce air around them. They seemed to be in a hurry to have Lin Ming go along with them. Their motivations were extremely suspicious. Otherwise, why would two peak bone forging martial artists try to pull in a boy that was only at the altering muscle stage? That was purely looking for trouble. Interesting. What do these people want? To kill me and take my possessions? Lin Ming maintained a composed expression. He neither agreed nor refused. With his current strength, it wouldn't be a problem to simply kill these two peak bone forging martial artists, so he wasn't afraid that they might have some diabolical plan they wanted to hatch. The monkey-faced man saw Lin Ming hesitate and hurriedly said, "Doesn't little brother wish to go deep within the southern wilderness to explore? There are many centuries-old herbs there, such as ginseng, lingzi, and other plants. We brothers are going on a treasure hunt at an ancient site, but this site has an array formation that takes at least three martial artists whose cultivation is at the altering muscle stage or above to open. If you go with us, then when we obtain the treasure, we will give 20% to you. How about it?" The monkey-faced man quickly gave a half-explanation as he found that Lin Ming seemed suspicious of them. But as he faced the monkey-faced man, Lin Ming had actually already used true essence sound transmission to speak to the two little girls behind him. He asked, "Are these two men your companions?" Seeing the two girls not respond, Lin Ming guessed that they weren't able to return a message through true essence sound transmission. He asked a different question. "If yes, then blink one eye. If no, then blink both eyes." As Lin Ming said this, The older girl didn't have any expression, but the slightly more childish-looking one blinked both eyes. Seeing this, Lin Ming was suddenly aware of the situation. These two men were not good people. Are they holding you by force? If yes, then blink one eye. If no, then blink two eyes. The little girl blinked one eye. They really were being forcefully held by these two men. Lin Ming thought that things were finally becoming interesting. What reason was there for these two men to kidnap these two young girls? Were they planning on selling them to martial artists to use for some nefarious reason? Was it true that they are going to some ancient site to look for treasures? This time the little girl immediately blinked one eye. It seemed that there was indeed some ancient site. He said that he needed three martial artists at least at the altering muscle stage to open the array formation of that ancient site. Is this also true? The little girl blinked her eye again. This time, the older girl glared at the younger one, and the little girl suddenly acted as if there was a child that had done something wrong, and timidly lowered her head. Lin Ming was a bit puzzled. What was the matter between these four people? At this moment, a girl's voice sounded in his mind. Although this voice was young, it was very chilling. If you don't want to die, then hurry up and leave. If you go now, then it might not be too late. Lin Ming looked at the older girl with incredulity. Unbelievable. She obviously could use true essence sound transmission, so why didn't she speak to him before? He hadn't thought that this harmless-looking girl would speak a few words in such an icy tone the first time she opened her mouth. At this time, the two men suddenly realized that Lin Ming was speaking to Na-Yi through true essence sound transmission. The monkey-faced man cunningly smiled. With a half-step, he and the bald man had already assumed a pincer-like position around Lin Ming, and had sealed his path. He still asked in an agreeable manner, "Little brother, how about it? Would you like to go with us?" The bald man also smiled and said, "Little brother, you should seriously consider this, otherwise you might regret it." Although these two men were smiling, their fake expressions contained a faint hint of murderous intent. They had never considered Lin Ming a threat in their minds. To them, he was only a little boy at the altering muscle stage, while they were two peak bone forging martial artists. To deal with him was a simple task. However, these two men didn't know that Lin Ming also had a similar plan. With his Thunderfire Annihilation, he could kill a pulse condensation martial artist, and these two men were only at the peak bone forging stage. He probably wouldn't even need to use Thunderfire Annihilation in order to kill them. What he was interested in was the ancient site. If he killed these two fellows now, then he wouldn't have anyone to bring him there. Listening to these two, it seemed that it was true that there needed to be three martial artists at least at the altering muscle stage working together. If he eliminated them both, then he wouldn't have any method to enter. Lin Ming decided to use their own plan against them. He would pretend that he was some useless rich junior of some large family that had never seen a world, and then let these two men relax their guard. If these two men still dared to do anything once they reached the ancient site, then Lin Ming didn't mind lending them a hand and sending them on their way to hell. Of course, he would also take the treasure there while he was at it. Now, the girl's icy-sounding true essence sound transmission echoed in his mind again. "I asked you to leave and yet you didn't, and still talked so much nonsense. Now they suspect that you know something. It's already impossible for them to let you go. You can only hope for the best from here on out." After this, the older girl no longer spoke. Her cute and pretty face had gone as cold as ice. Lin Ming thought this was quite funny. He hadn't denied anything or said he was going to do anything. In fact, he was prepared to take a nice trip with these two men. What treasures would there be at the end of this ancient site? What was the risk factor and just what dangers were there? Lin Ming had many doubts, but it appeared that the older girl wasn't willing to answer him. The little girl seemed more agreeable, but she could only blink. If he asked these questions, then it would be impossible for him to get a clear answer just from her blinking eyes. Thinking this, Lin Ming suddenly acted bashful, and gratefully smiled as he said, "Two big brothers are very gracious. This is truly the first time that I've come to the southern wilderness, and I am unfamiliar with the land and the people. Also, my cultivation isn't high, and the road is surrounded with danger. If two big brothers are willing to take me, then that would really be too good." Hearing Lin Ming say this, the monkey-faced man was a bit taken aback. Was this fellow stupid, or just fake stupid?